In some special cases, it is not hard at all to determine whether a set S is linearly independent or not. Well, quite a lot of cases actually. That is because you can sometimes see immediately that one of the vectors has to be a linear combination of the others. So the set is dependent. Or because you can see that no vector can be a linear combination of the others. So the set is independent. In this video, we will learn in what examples you can see straight away whether a set is independent or not. Well, the first case is if you have a set of only two vectors. Well, the set is independent if one of the members is a linear combination of all the others. Well, if you have only two members, then the set is linearly independent of the first one if the first one is a linear combination of the second one. And it can only be the case if the first one and the second one are multiples of each other. So, in a set of two vectors, you only have to look whether the vectors are multiples of each other or not. So, if we look at our set S1, we have this consisting of 1, 2, and 2, 3, we see they are not multiples of each other, so this set S1 is independent. Whereas, if we look at S2, consisting of 1, 2, and 2, 4, we see 2, 4 equals 2 times 1, 2, so 2, 4 is a multiple of 1, 2, so those are dependent, which means that the set S2 is dependent. So sets of two vectors are really easy. We have some more easy cases. Suppose we are in R2 and we have two vectors, U1 and U2. Just put two vectors over there, and suppose they are independent. What happens if I try to put one more vector, for example, over here? Now you see this third vector is immediately a linear combination of U1 and U2. In this case, 1 times U1 plus 1 times U2. Or if I would try to put, for example, this one, and this one is also a linear combination of U1 and U2, namely 0 times U2 plus 1 half times U1, so also a linear combination. No matter what you try, you cannot make more than two linearly independent vectors in R2. So R2 contains at most two independent vectors, and that goes on. R3 contains at most three independent vectors, etc., etc. So you can look at S3. If you have more vectors than you have entries, then you know for sure that your set is dependent. So R3, you have vectors in R3, you have four vectors. In R3, you can form sets which contain at most three independent vectors. We have four over here. So this one is dependent. And then the next example. Any set containing the zero vector is automatically dependent. Because if you have, apart from the zero vector, some other factors in your set, you can always write zero vector equals 0 times U1 plus 0 times U2. So you can always express zero vectors in terms of the other vectors. If you have a very silly set consisting of only the zero vector, and this set is also linearly dependent, for that you can use the definition. So set containing the zero vector is always dependent. So that's also a case in which you can easily see whether your set is dependent or not. Now we go to the next case. If I have vectors in R3, if I have four vectors, I know they are dependent. If I have two vectors, I can look at multiples. But what about a set with vectors in R3 containing three vectors? What can I do then? Well, then I have to be careful. Can I again look at multiples? Well, if you look at S5, for example, we see the vectors are not multiples of each other. And if we look at S6, we also see that the vectors are not multiples of each other. So would be tempted to conclude that both sets are independent. But that's wrong. If you have more than two vectors and they are not multiples of each other, then you cannot conclude that the set is independent or not. Well, why is that? If you look at S5, it's clear that the set is independent. However, if you look at S6, we see that the third vector equals the first plus second one. So this one is independent and this one is dependent. So even though the vectors are not multiples of each other. So, if you have a set of more than two vectors, then be careful. If you don't observe that vectors are multiples of each other, then you don't know yet whether the set is dependent or independent. In that case, you will have to use the definition